Hello everybody, so we have a lot to catch up, so let's jump straight into it. Alright, so the biggest update was what we called with the community the NeoVox update. So Starship Evo started its life as a voxel building game. Then quickly we added the bricks, then the stretchable bricks. And today the last remnant of the voxel tech have been removed. So what does it mean for you? So now you can change the grid scale of a brick from 12 cm up to 32 meters. So now the codex has been made a lot simpler as we no longer need a small and a large version. Now you can build pretty much any size you want. But the real kicker is that you can build big. Very, very big. So not only it will be much easier for you to build big using large brick, but the memory impact has been drastically reduced. So this ship will never have been possible using voxel, but now the only factor is brick count, not size. And bricks are really super light in memory, so for example, take this crazy ship made by Dolan made of more than 200,000 bricks, and it is only weighing 20 megabytes in RAM. But for me, the most important thing is that the code base has been made a lot simpler. That being said, it was really hard to pull off as I had to ensure compatibility with your older blueprints. Now, let's jump into mission. So finally, the work is well underway. As a good first step to develop the framework, I decided to nuke the old tutorial and do something more integrated to explain the base of the game. The player will undergo a quick tutorial on how to use his jetpack, then go to the training center to tackle a quick basic training on building. This training center platform will be used for more advanced training later on so the player can discover the game at his own pace. Then finally, he will have to set up the system of a lovely mini repair ship and then fly it around the station to fix 3 technical modules. One end goal is to use the scripting language called LUA so players can also create their own mission scripts. This will act as the first foray into modding. Mission will be a big focus on the short term, so stay tuned. So you'll have noticed, but we also have brand new stations, so they are really, really incredible. A massive thanks to Surge for all the modules. And yeah, they come with full interior, they are really looking fantastic. It almost feels like no longer a building game given the amount of polish and detail we have. The generation algorithm have also been improved and more modules will be added soon. So inside the station hub interior, we are now spawning a wide variety of kiosks. So while some kiosks are mainly decorative, well at least for now, some others will facilitate key components of the gameplay, like the mission board, the repair station or the refuel station. And again, a massive thanks to all the builders. I think their creation will bring a lot of life and personality to the game. It was really a joy to integrate everything into the game. And I can't wait to start really working on crowd and crew to add some life to all of this. And to stay on the topic of new in-game creation, we also have new pirates and tankers roaming the world. So a massive thanks to all the builders. Alright, thanks a lot for watching the video. So if you really would like to help me and already own the game, it will be really kind of you to leave a review on the Steam page. Fuel is gonna be a thing in Starship Evo. You will need to harvest, store and manage fuel through your ship. I have now focused on the fuel technology. So reactor requires fuel to produce power and fuel will automatically flow from tanks to reactor. So the game don't become a piping hell, I'll make sure that you can build pipe through whole block. And also added some debugging features so you can understand what is happening. You can use a valve to stop the flow and use transparent bricks and tanks to check the fuel level. More features will be added soon like fuel harvesting and crafting, and also more systems will require some type of fuel to function. So copy-paste was one of the most requested features. It has now been improved with the ability to copy logic and mechanism. So now you can copy entire landing gear or turrets. Better yet, you can export a clipboard selection and create a prefab to be used at a later point. You can create your own prefab library or share or download other people's creation from the workshop. So a lot of progress has been made on the physics engine side of the game. So I was using a mix of Unity own engine, physics by Nvidia, and my own cooking. And now it is 100% custom, which fixes a few issues I had with the large scale of the world. And most importantly, this offers some massive speed up. So for example, collision or moving mechanism no longer lag. The new framework is built using Unity new data-oriented technology, which I have to say is absolutely staggering. So in short, it minimizes memory access and fully uses your processor power, which leads to code running often 100 times faster, which is really crazy stuff. On top of that, I can run most of the code on ParallelTrail, making it essentially free. So this was running so well that I was able to unplug the voxel code on the physics side, which leads to the NeoVox update I told you about. Alright, so now let's go through in rapid fire mode a bunch of other cool features that were added to the game. Glowing Brick was also a much requested feature. They come in various shapes. The new RGB controller allows you to add some really cool dynamic effect to light. And it works with the new glow block too. The multiplane symmetry was another highly requested feature. The light tech was completely overhauled. Now light behave more correctly inside ship. The lightning is sharper and metal looks like real metal. You can also have very large light to lighten up your hangar. The ambient occlusion post effect was added. It will help make your interior pop. A new build option menu has been added. Press F1 to open it and customize a few options. Now glowing brick like thruster and lights will emit a nice up glow at a distance, so things will pop more when viewed far away. That's it guys, thanks a lot for following the game and see you in the next one.